pause the video and attempt this question. When you are ready, play the video again. All right. Now, remember that we cannot use the general power rule, the power rule anymore, because here, the n here, the power is actually -1. So basically here, we need to ask the question, what do I need to differentiate in order to get 1 over x? Very good. We differentiate natural log of x, for example. When we differentiate natural log of x, then the answer to this is 1 over x. So here, what I need to put is natural log of x plus c. Next question. What do I have to integrate to get 2? Well, that's easy. Constant slope. So we need to integrate a linear function. So in this case, 2 to the power of x, 2 times x plus 2 times x plus c. So you can think of this as x raised to the power of 0, and then 0 plus 1 divided by 0 plus 1. So it's 2x plus c. Right? Over here, well, this is similar to a part. Therefore, the answer here will be kx plus c. Very good. So next, we look at this question. We need to show that these two things are exactly the same. You may want to try this. Once you're ready, press the play button again. Welcome back. So let's try the first part. Integrate 2x to the power of 7 dx. What is this going to be? Well, 2x, 7 plus 1, that's 8, divided by 8 plus c. So this is 2 to the x to the power of 8. 2 over 8 is just going to be 2 divided by 8 is 1/4 plus c. That's the first part. The second part is this. 2 times the integration of x to the power of 7 dx. So this is going to be 2 bracket x raised to the power of 8 divided by 8 plus I'm going to have c1, for example. So this is going to be x to the power of 8 over 4 plus c1 over 2. Now, I can let c1 over 2 to be c. Therefore, you can see that the answer here and the answer above are exactly the same. Therefore, I finished the work. In fact, now you can form a generalization. That is, when you have a function times a multiple, a constant multiple, the constant multiple can come out of the integration sign to become like this. It can come out of the integration sign. Now let's try question number 5. Okay, the first step is to rewrite this as x to the power of -1/5 plus 2x to the power of 3 dx. So x -1/5 plus 1, -1/5 plus 1 is actually 4/5, so 4/5 down here, plus 2x to the power of 3 plus 1 is 4, so divided by 4 plus c. So answer to this is 5 over 4 x to the power -1/5 plus 1 is 4/5, and then plus 2 over 4 is half, x to the power of 4 plus c. That's the answer. The next one is that, well, we don't always have to write it with respect to x. We can also have it with respect to t or some other variable that is depending on your need. So in this particular function, everything is in t, so it's with respect to t. Right? So I'm going to rewrite this as t cubed minus, this is t to the power of half raised to the power of 3 dt. That is integration of t cubed minus t 3 over 2 dt. So this is t to the power of 4 over 4, 3 plus 1 is 4, over the new index minus t t 3 half plus 1 over 3 half plus 1. 3 half plus 1 is going to be 5 over 2 plus c. So the answer to this is t to the power of 4 over 4 minus 2 fifth t to the power of 5 over 2 plus c. Do you get that right? Yes, excellent. So now we look at the last slide. The last slide asks you to summarize all the things that we have done in this video. All right, you may want to take a few minutes to do that. Once you're ready, you can check the answer. All right, welcome back. This is the power rule. N cannot be equal to negative 1. And here's the rule for the constant. And here's the rule for the constant of a multiple. See, the multiple comes out of the integration sign. And here's the rule for sum and difference. That is, basically, if you have a sum or a difference, you can treat this as taking the integration part by part. The part with f of x and the part with g of x separately. Thank you.